Hey, let's hear from the Word of God. I'm so proud of you for sticking with our devotional plan. The number one indicator of spiritual growth year over year is daily Bible reading. I'm happy to be a help to you through these. I hope that these help substantiate your faith. I want to encourage you, in addition to these brief devotions, use the other bookmark that's in your Bible to move on a fast track. Read through the whole Bible every year, in addition to the more deep dives that we do as we go verse by verse through the Gospel of John together. This is John chapter 20, beginning in verse 19. When it was evening of that first day of the week, the disciples were gathered together with the doors locked because they feared the Jews. Jesus came, stood among them, and said to them, "Peace be with you." Having said this, he showed them his hands and his side. So the disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. They were locked away. Which Jews in particular did they fear? Were these guys anti-Semites? No, they were ethnic Jews. Rather, they're afraid of the Jewish authorities that just oversaw the crucifixion of Jesus. If you'd recall, the trials that led to Jesus's crucifixion involved three different trials under Jewish authorities and then three trials under Roman authorities. He went before Annas, sort of the patriarchal permanent high priest, and then Caiaphas plus the Sanhedrin, the whole Jewish council. So the whole Jewish leadership, as they had been plotting since John chapter 11, after Jesus resurrected Lazarus from the dead, really wanted Jesus to be put to death. And they gave him an illegal death sentence at midnight. The only reason they went Roman with this thing, see Acts chapter 7, when they just stoned Stephen to death at, you know, a moment of passion, was so that it would be ratified and it would be crucifixion. So that's where you see Jesus go before Pilate and then Herod, Antipas, and then Pilate again. It was these Jewish authorities of whom the disciples were afraid. They've seen this intimidating effect that the Jewish council would have on people before. Do you remember the man who was born blind and was healed and whose parents refused to defend him for fear of being kicked out of the synagogue? The disciples felt the same way at first. Now, I don't want us to just sit, like, let's all just like gang up on the disciples and talk about how cowardly they are. I'd rather tell you this, it's these dudes who are scared, who in the book of Acts will be used by God, plus Matthias, new disciple, coming soon to apostleship near you, are gonna break history in half. The Holy Spirit of God is gonna pour out. These guys who are currently hiding away scared are the ones through whom God will break history in half. We measure history itself based around the birth of Jesus Christ. It is year zero on the Gregorian calendar. It has no year one. So right here at the very center of history is the birth of Christ. And we measure that because Christ started it, of course, and he finished the cost of our sin on the cross. But the worldwide global effects of the ministry of God would largely be realized through these 11 disciples plus the 12th, Matthias, coming next. They were afraid. You know what you have in common with the ones through whom God broke history in half? You're both afraid. We're both fearful at times. Fearful of rejection, fearful of professional consequences, fearful of social consequences, fearful of being trolled on social media for sharing what we believe or sharing hope in the gospel. We're both afraid. So if you have fear in your heart at the thought of letting your faith be known to your coworkers, your teammates, the people who live in on your cul-de-sac, your family members, if you have fear, guess what you have in common with the disciples? Fear. They were afraid of the Jews, but then Jesus showed up, and I pray that he shows up for you too. The very first words that he said were, "Peace be with you." And we'll talk more about that tomorrow as to why he said, "Peace be with you." Peace indeed. My brother, my sister in Christ, peace be with you. Go light up someone's darkness today.